Everybody wants to lose weight. Everybody wants to be healthy. Everybody wants to be fit. Nobody wants to be overweight. Nobody wants to be sick. Nobody wants to get old. Nobody wants pain and inflammation and to lose their mobility. And yet it's an ongoing struggle year in and year out for us to try and maintain a healthy weight, to not be ill, to stay off medication, and to not feel the rigors of age on an annual basis after, say, the age of 50. Why is it so difficult? It shouldn't be so difficult because these things aren't all that complicated. So welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I'm a sportsman. I've been very unfit and unhealthy and overweight. And at the moment, I'm in good shape. I'm in a much better place physically and mentally. I'm 61 years old and I'm feeling and operating much better than I have been for decades. So how did I do it? How do the people who follow me do it? No tricks, no magic. No money, nothing. What is key to maintaining your health or improving your health and maintaining a healthy weight and keeping your marbles is knowledge. Without the proper knowledge and the proper understanding of how these things work, you're very unlikely to be successful. So the world is full of experts who will tell you what you need to do. They will tell you that you can fix all your problems with diet, whether that's a very, very restrictive diet or a very, very complicated diet that requires you to buy lots of products. They will tell you that you cut out certain things and you eat other things and all your problems will be solved. That's not true. There are people who will tell you that you just need to exercise. You just need to start running. That's not true either. There are people that will tell you that the key to permanent good health in your later years is yoga or some other kind of mindfulness or stress management. That's not true either. You can't imagine yourself to health. That's ridiculous. There will be people who tell you you need a procedure, you need a gadget, you need a supplement, you need a medication. And that's not right either. But guess what? They're all right, really. The point is, there is no key to this issue because it's not that kind of lock. It's a combination lock and you need numbers and you need all the numbers. Otherwise, the door doesn't open. And that's the point. Diet, exercise, mindfulness, mental approach, supplements where necessary, so long as you understand what they're for. Medication where necessary, so long as you understand what it's for and you have a plan to get past the need for medication. Stress management, sleep, all those things are important. So you need them in combination. And the more you go to experts, the more you get funneled into one silo and you go down a rabbit hole and nothing else matters. Surgeons will always tell you you need surgery. Physiotherapists will tell you that you need some kind of manipulation. A sports coach will tell you that you just need to exercise. A dietitian will give you a diet and tell you what to eat, even if they're wrong, following government guidelines and telling you to eat all sorts of nonsense that increases inflammation and makes you even fatter. So what you need to do is learn. You need to understand, at least on a basic level, the biochemistry of your body and what works and what affects your health? What actually affects your weight? What actually affects your strength and your mobility and your levels of inflammation and pain? What actually affects your hormone regulation to keep your mood right so that you can concentrate better, so that you're not so anxious? All these things work together. So stay close to us. Subscribe to this channel. Watch our videos. We talk about all those things. But we do it in a way that you understand it so that you can make decisions based on some understanding of the biochemistry and of what's actually going on in your body. I had somebody ask me for help, and when I started to explain some of the basics, she immediately threw up her arms and said, don't explain it all to me. I don't have time for that. Just tell me what to do. And I said, I can't help you. You need to find somebody else. Because I don't do that, because I don't agree with that. She'll listen to me, do some of the things I say, then she'll listen to someone else, then she'll listen to someone else, and she has no ability to filter the advice and the information and compare it to her actual knowledge of how these things work. And if you have at least a basic knowledge of biochemistry and how your body works and your anatomy and your physiology, you can see very quickly when something is BS or likely to be BS, and you can go and look it up again and reference it, and you can go and read up and understand what you're reading. And for me, that is gold. So what I try to do on this channel is explain these things. Okay, why do we not eat sugar? What does it actually do? How does it work? What's the explanation? When someone says you must have carbohydrates, okay, let's not have an argument about whether or not you need sugar in your diet. Let's talk about the biochemistry and the body's processes. And you explain to me why carbohydrates and sugar are so important and you can't live without them. That is impossible because you don't need them. So you can filter out this kind of nonsense. Join this channel, subscribe to our channel, come with us for a journey, make this the year that you learn about yourself and you own your health. Your doctor doesn't own it, your dietitian doesn't own it, your personal trainer doesn't own it. Yes, use them, refer to them, ask them questions. Take their recommendations into account, but compare them with what you've learned and with what other people say, and combine all the advice that you trust to build a project for yourself that works for you, so that you have the best nutrition, the best exercise regime. Now, exercise doesn't mean doing a sport. It can just be, it's just movement. Best exercise for you, given your circumstances. Stress management, how to get better sleep, what habits to start cutting out, and you will then finally succeed in a way that is sustainable. So you will have much better health, much more fun. You'll have more fun. Make this a year that you have fun, but you've got to be healthy to have fun. And to be healthy, you've got to be physically healthy and you've got to be mentally healthy. So subscribe to this channel. Look back through our videos. We've done hundreds of videos on various aspects of health, whether it's nutrition or exercise or stress management or diving into the ins and outs of particular supplements and vitamins, all that stuff. And learn as much as you can, because if you understand how it works, then you are able to make it work for you. Thank you for subscribing to our channel. Please share this video. Please, let's get as many people as we can onto this project.